as a man who leads a life of danger. To everyone he meets, he stays a stranger. Every move he makes, another chance he takes. Odds are he won't live to see tomorrow.
Oh my gosh, brings back fun memories. And speaking of secret agents, meet my favorite former secret agent, Jamie Soucy.
Hi guys, thank you so much for joining us on this Monday. I am Jamie Soucy. I'm so excited to be here this morning. I was born and raised in Boston, Massachusetts, and I'm a recent transplant to Phoenix, Arizona. I am the mom to four kids, yes, four. My amazing husband's name is Corey, and I have a background in nursing. As cliche as it sounds, I really wanted to help people. I worked for 12 years in the cardiac intensive care unit at Boston Children's Hospital. I had job security, I had a pension, I had retirement. My parents taught me growing up that you better have a great credit score and something really good to retire on. So in other words, my parents really taught me to play kind of small. Here's what I loved about nursing. I knew that I'd always have a job. I was literally saving lives of babies who were born with or who had acquired heart disease. And I got to wear pajamas to work. It wasn't a bad gig. I loved making impacts at work, but what I also loved were my own kids at home that were missing a present mom. That pain became so painful that I knew I needed to make a change. So along came a little skincare company in the direct selling channel. I understood with that company very quickly the power of passive income, owning a business, and really owning your own schedule. I could also be the present mom that I wanted to be for those kids. I wanted to teach them so much more than just having a great credit score. I wanted to teach them to own their lives, to play big, and to be a leader in whatever field that they chose. This skincare company was great, but I needed something else. I wasn't making enough impacts that I so badly wanted to. So that skincare, while it was a great chapter, I was looking for something else. And then along came a coaching opportunity. And I thought, maybe this is it. I can be a small business coach. I can train, I can coach, I can inspire people. But what I underestimated was what it takes to be in business by myself. Marketing costs, I had to pay for that. Images, lead generation, I mean, leads didn't even exist. It was getting hard and I was going into debt. And there goes that credit score that I was working so hard and my mom was going to be so disappointed in me. So then came a phone call with Sara last year about the Symmetry opportunity. I remember hearing insurance and I thought, yuck, there's no way. Has Sara lost her mind? My husband quickly reminded me that I always stay open-minded and that everyone does need insurance. So I listened. Sara introduced me to Jacob Pogue, and I was immediately drawn to him and thought, I want to get behind whatever this guy is doing with this company. And to be honest, I suffer from FOMO. I did not want Sara to go out there and get rich without me. Plus, I thought, what do I have to lose? Nothing else is really going for me. I called my mom, or maybe I sent her a text, and I told her I was going to build some generational wealth for my kids, and I was going to go all in. I planted my flag. And just like anything I've ever done, I said, if I'm going to do this, I'm going to do it to the best of my ability with no regrets. That was in March of 2020. So now I get to show my kids that with hard work, tenacity, and a whole lot of hustle, you really can have it all. Speaking of having it all, I want you to meet my friend and my partner in crime, Sara Reineke.
Oh my gosh, thank you, Jamie. I never get tired of hearing your story and how you got here. Yes, my name is Sara Reineke and I'm a teacher by trade. I taught school for 16 years, third grade for 13 years and 3 years of junior high. So 16 years of that. And I loved it. I loved the impact. I was addicted to the impact and the intrinsic reward that comes from that. But I also really remember the financial trauma that came from that industry. I had two part-time jobs, along with working full-time and three kids. all to make about $2,400 a month, I remember. And that was with a master's degree and a specialist degree and two Teacher of the Year awards. And it didn't matter how hard I worked. I made the same as that guy across the hall that was putting in about 10% effort when I was putting in 110% effort. Which is why I stumbled upon the same skincare company. And actually, we didn't know each other whenever we both were with that same company. And I just needed to bring about an extra $500 a month home to pay for travel ball and preschool. And it did that and more. And it grew and grew and grew so much so that I surpassed my teacher's salary by 4 or 5 times and was able to walk away from teaching to do that full time. And what's crazy is the day that I told my principal that I was walking away, he said, as I had applied for several administrative jobs, I really thought I was supposed to lead people in the educational world, but I got second place several times. Because whenever in education, you give your paperwork over, your resume to a board of education, a committee, they hold on to it for 3 to 4 weeks and they decide your future. And I had decided after learning what I was capable of and what was out there in the real world that I could do more, right? So whenever I told him I was leaving, he said, Sara, this is really bad timing. Today, the assistant principal resigned and I was going to talk to you about taking that position. And I told him, with all due respect and thank you so, so much, but if I can keep the rest of my life from having to hand that paperwork over to a committee of people and keep the ball in my court, that's what I plan on doing. And I walked out and haven't looked back, but I knew I was giving that up forever, you know, when I walked away from that. That business grew and I was so grateful for that. It taught me that I could grow my own business. Until it wasn't. Businesses like that have a cycle. This was no different. And I knew I needed a supplement. And along came coaching. That's actually where Jamie and I met, was at coaching school. So we became business coaches and we built that business one client at a time. And we were like, oh my gosh, if we don't get one more client, we can't pay a house payment. If we lose a client, we can't make a car payment. And that was really frustrating. So I knew that wasn't our end game. I just knew it wasn't. And I started, and that's about the time that I sold my business, mostly because I needed to have money in the bank and I was needed to move forward and burn the ships there. So made that decision, sold the business and knew, like, is it real estate? Is it mortgage? What is it? And because I looked at State Farm, a friend of mine from that same skincare company said, hey, you need to meet Jacob Pogue and look at Symmetry. And I was like, can I be an insurance agent? Kids is possible. But I dare you to say no to Jacob. I just do. And I beat him up for 2 weeks. And I said, I'll be worth it, but I have more questions. I'll be worth it, but I have more questions. And so hopefully I've been worth it, Jacob. Thanks for putting up with me. But I just knew I wanted to plant my flag and make it my last stop. And so I did, planted my flag, and that was March 2020. And we all know what happened soon after. I just wanted to add this in here that I was so impressed with how the founders handled it, how the leaders handled it. We were watching from afar. We'd planted our flag, but it definitely wasn't in concrete. We're like, we'll see how they handle this. And what we saw is no one cried, no one panicked. They pivoted beautifully. There was telesales training and Zoom training overnight, and everyone just moved with it and leaned into it. And we were so impressed with that. We thought, this is our place. This is where we're going to go. So we're so, so grateful that we said yes and we planted our flag, and we knew these are founders we can trust and leaders we can get behind in a company that we can just plant our flag and go. So it was our last stop. We made a decision. So that being said though, Jane, when we made the decision that this was going to be our last stop, we were like, but we're not going to tell anyone, right? Like, this is top secret. No one has to know. We can work together every day, but no one we know has to know, right?
Yeah, that's exactly what we thought. And when we found out that Jacob Pogue has built his business by using ZipRecruiter and just the lead system, we never had a lead system where we came from before. It was kind of like a breath of fresh air, right? If he can do it, we can do it. So sign us up.
Right. Yeah, top secret. And there's a lot of reasons to be a top secret agent. Let's go over a few of the really great reasons to be a secret agent here.
Well, Sara, no one you know can say no, because that would hurt your feelings.
And I don't want my feelings hurt. And if I quit, or if we quit, we fail, that way no one we know will know that we ever started or quit or failed.
Yeah, no one's going to dodge you in the aisles of Target or hide from you at the family reunions. That's embarrassing.
Mm-hmm. And I don't want to have to answer questions from people that I know. And if I don't know the answer, that's embarrassing. I don't want to have to do that.
Yeah, Jacob did it. We can do it too. So, but Sara, we built businesses before using social media, right? Mm-hmm. We've done it. So why would we not do it again? I mean, we've just mentioned that this is going to be our last stop. So why would we not go out there and tell the world what we're doing? Because we know it works.
Okay. I like the way you're thinking, Jamie, Susie.
So guys, we began to wonder, what if we do that now? What if we do both? We know Jacob did this with cold market in the lead system. And we know Ryan Miller did this with warm market all at the same time. What if we both did that, Sara? What could our business look like a year from now if we threw ourselves 100% all in to both?
Right. Yeah. What if we stopped being a secret agent?
Yeah. I mean, what if we leveraged our warm market along with the lead system?
Right. Guys, we made this decision about 2 months in. Our first month in the field was June, and August was when we're like, maybe we should not be top secret. So it took us a couple of months to figure this out. And so we want to share with you what this can look like for you and not to be secret agent any longer.
Yeah. So, all right, guys, we're open for business. We're 100% committed. Who actually knows you're open, right? There are multiple ways to show that you're open here at Symmetry. Have you ever tried going to a local coffee shop or a bakery and the lights are off and the hours are weird and they don't have a sign out front? Eventually, you're going to stop going there. Maybe you had a really great pastry or a great coffee one day, but they're not showing their commitment to their business. So you're going to stop going.
Right. And commitment's important in all things. In our marriage, I don't think that Jared and Corey would be happy if we were 73% committed to our marriage, right? So let's talk about some ways that we show 100% commitment to Symmetry, because we knew, we're like, man, if we can do that, then I think we can leverage our warm and our cold market. So what are some ways that we could do that?
Yeah, 100%. So social media updates are one example. We're not talking just utilizing social media, but it is a pretty big piece of it. There are other ways to show that you're open to.
Yeah. And if you're going to use social media, you have to be consistent. You know, if Target, Walmart, Budweiser, Coca-Cola, if they all consistently put out commercials and advertise, you probably should be committed to being consistent as well.
Yeah. I mean, other examples, you can get business cards. You can get the Symmetry merchandise. I mean, we all know Roddy Jessup loves wearing that Symmetry polo shirt to all his Zooms.
Right. But what if you wore that Symmetry merchandise and you wore it to your Rotary Club or Kiwanis Club or a Chamber Leads event or a First Friday coffee, or, you know, just wore it to work at the coffee shop down the street?
Sara, did you know that Quillity will make you a logo for free? I mean, you can post that. You could put it on your business card. You could share that with the world.
Right. You can get the owner's circle so you can have your own website. You could add that to your business card.
Yeah. I mean, conference calls, just like one we're on right now, like we have to learn here, like our life and our livelihood depends on it, because it does.
And if you're going to be 100% committed, the person who should know that first is your mentor, but don't say it unless you mean it. You need to go to them and say, all right, I'm all in, 100% committed. What does that look like? Will you hold me accountable? We know from our coaching background that that's so, so important. So work with your mentor and be accountable to them.
Yeah, smart. So what we're really saying here, Sara, is that we need to be sharing this opportunity unapologetically.
Absolutely. And guys, if we want to accomplish what we say we want to accomplish, and if you're on this call right now, then you're someone who invests in yourself and you want to, you know, work towards those really big goals that we all want to work towards, you really have no choice but to be 100%, unless you want to drag this out for 20 years, right? We wanted the fastest route from A to B. I asked Jacob over and over, can we skip steps? He said, no. Okay, then what's the fastest route from A to B? You probably want that too. So let's just get all 100% in.
Yeah. So we shared earlier, Sara, some super valid reasons of why it's okay to be a secret agent, right? What if we share the benefits of coming out of the darkness and sharing with the world what it is that we do?
Yeah. Get your pens ready, because you're getting ready to get some pro tips from the Jamie Soucy.
So in terms of utilizing social media, you can let your family and friends know what you do, right? A click of a button is going to reach hundreds, if not thousands of people. Social media is 100% free. It is simple. I'm telling you, it is not hard to use. It can take less than 10 minutes a day. And my favorite thing, Sara, is it's going to at least double your productivity and your favorite word, profitability.
Right. In our agency, we say all the time, the two biggest ingredients is culture and a path to profitability. And if we've got both of those things, people will stay, right? So that's what we talk about every single huddle that we have. And guys, since we decided to go 100% all in, we both submitted over 75,000 our first 6 months in business. We both hit agency owner within our first year. We have a team culture that so many people are excited to be a part of. We have 30 writing agents. Right now we're sitting at 26 on the 12th of the month. We are on a very clear path to 120, and we're taking as many people and agents along with us that want to go with us. And we have zero regrets about this.
Yep. Yep. So what is it that you want your network to feel, or, you know, the people that see your posts on social media, what is it that you want them to think about you when they see them? They want to know that you're having fun. They want to know that you love what you're doing, and they want to know that you're part of a winning, happy team and you happen to be learning a ton too.
Right. I had a friend reach out to me and say, it is so fun to see you love what you're doing. That was literally the words that she sent me. They want to know that you're a part of a team. People want to be a part of a winning team. They just do. Right. And they want to know that you're profitable, that you're making money. They're curious about it. Like, is she really making money doing that? They want to know that you're helping people and that you have time freedom. Like, hey, wait a minute. She's always able to go to her daughter's assembly or pick up her kids from school or make it to that, dentist appointment. That's intriguing to people who are stuck in their cubicles.
That's the best value proposition we have here at Symmetry is time and money. I don't know where else you can go get what we have here. They want to know that you're part of a stable industry, that you have advancement in technology. We put $20 million into Quility, that it's a sustainable, safe industry. It's not going anywhere, and that there's room for them. We want other people to see that there's an unlimited growth potential here.
Right. And most importantly, balanced. If this is the word of the day from our training today, is that your brand needs to be balanced, because the last thing you want is for your friends and family to be like, my gosh, she says the word insurance one more time, right? You want to be multifaceted. Insurance and Symmetry is a part of who you are, but it is not all of who you are. There's way more to you. Your kids, their activities, maybe you like wine or coffee or reading or golf or rock climbing or crocheting. You have some things that are important about you that you need to share along with insurance. So we use something called a branding matrix. And this is something I have literally just drawn this matrix down, 10 circles down the side on the left and 3 circles on the top. So don't think it has to be this fancy, just draw it with a pen and paper. And we do this every single month because your months are different. You know, last year, this time I was a football mom and now my son graduated. So now I'm a cheer mom. I'm owning it, right? So it looks a little bit different. Last year I was talking about football. Now I'm posting cheer pictures. Okay. So everything you put out on social media should either, and really not just in social media, in general, your conversations at parties or Christmas parties or that fall festival, you should either be educating, entertaining, or empowering. And if it doesn't fall in those three categories, then don't say it or don't post it. I promise you, it's not going to help in any way, shape, or form. Over on the left-hand side, that is you, what's important to you. And if you don't know me at all and you follow me on social media, you know that I like to shop local and eat local. I love wine. I love coffee. I love craft beer, finding little breweries. I like to cook. I have a cheerleader. I love my husband. I love Symmetry. I love my faith. I love to read. Those are things that you're going to know really quickly. If you follow Jamie, you're going to know that she gets a shaken ice espresso brown sugar with coconut milk every single day. She's got a baby named Charlie and she loves her husband. She goes on date nights with him all the time. She's got a beautiful pool. You can tell. Those are things that you know about us, even if you've never met us in person, because we post more than just about insurance. So down on the left-hand side, those topics, that's about you. So number one, if you're writing this down, make the number one topic Symmetry, just for an example. And number two could be health. Hopefully that's on all of our categories. I got up this morning and worked out, Jane. I did that. So just for this training today. So let's talk about the first one being Symmetry. Okay. So Jamie, what's a way that we can educate on social media regarding Symmetry?
We could talk about cancer coverage.
Right. You could talk about disability coverage, accidental death policies. There's a million ways, but here's the thing that people fall into is that they want to only do Symmetry educate. And if you're only Symmetry educating, your network's going to get bored and unfollow, right? So that's one of your categories. What's a way that you could be kind of funny about Symmetry?
Well, I did a post a couple weeks ago, and it was a post about where you can earn a living. Where else can you go to earn a living wearing Target yoga pants and slippers in our work from home opportunity?
Yep, it was cute. People were talking about it. I've seen her post a picture of her baby like chewing on leads, like out of the trash. You know, she's like, this is working from home, you know, trying to wrestle the baby. It's cute. It's funny. In empowerment, you might post about someone on your team that got a promotion or, you know, you just watched a really cool speech or something like that. Let's go to number two. Let's talk about your health. So an educational post might be, hey, I posted a picture of me in my gown on the day that I got my last mammogram. Hey, make sure that you get your mammograms every single year. I can educate about breast cancer awareness. Entertainment. I posted one day about, I got blood drawn. And when I walked in, they said, oh, let's get the fainting sofa for her. I'm like, you remember me being a fainter from last year? This is humiliating. And I posted this fainting sofa, like making fun of myself. And then an empowerment post, the day in CrossFit that I jumped on that box. And if any of you have ever jumped in the box jump, that 90 degree angle is frightening. And someone videotaped it for me in slow motion. And I posted that and I did a whole thing about, you know, being brave and posted that about my health, right? So the reason you want to think about it this way is this gives you lots of ideas. If you love your pets, make that number three. I talk about my dog named Kitty, you know, and funny things that she might do. Come up with all the things about you. And then this is going to give you tons of ideas. When you say, I just can't think of things to post about, this is your tool every single month. What's going on, right? So maybe in a different time of the, you might have Easter, you might have baseball, right? You don't have Easter and baseball right now. Right now it's going to be fall activities and football or soccer, whatever you've got going on. So hopefully this makes sense. I would write this out every single month so you can plan out your posts.
Yeah, Sarah, this is such a great way to look at your social media feed, whether it's Instagram or Facebook or LinkedIn, wherever your social media platform of choice is, and just scroll a little bit and see, does it look like a TV commercial that you would keep following, or is it just insurance, 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 insurance? Because if it turns you off, it's probably turning your network off too. So this will really help keep you on track for the entire month.
Absolutely.
All right. So if it doesn't fit into the list we just talked about, then it's a no. It's a no for me. We don't want to post about it. So things that should never go on social media are politics, controversial topics. Guys, we want to attract people from all sides of all the fences. We don't want to post about curse words, negativity. Nobody really cares that you're stuck in traffic or that you had a really bad day. That's not something that's attractive. You may have somebody that woke up thinking, I need to get coverage today, and they go to your page and see that you are in a really bad mood. They're probably not going to reach out to you, and you just lost the opportunity to make a sale. No one wants to know when you're sick. And then one other tip is exact copies. You don't want to copy paste exactly what somebody else does. And the purpose of that is because it's not authentic to you. It's not your own voice. And it changes the algorithm of social media. And what that means is less eyes will see what you're putting out there.
Right. And this is just something to remember. And I heard this a long time ago. When you're looking at social media, it's feed, 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 take. Feed, 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 take. And what that means is if you're just posting social media about insurance, you're taking, 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 and your network's going to get real tired of that. So you might post a recipe for your favorite meatloaf. You might post, one day I posted, did you know that Jimmy John's offers an unwich wrapped in lettuce? And they're like, yes, Sarah, old news. But there was like 85 comments of like, I had no idea. That's as silly as that sounds. That's value. If you're a golfer, hey, I just played at this new golf course. It's just 30 miles away. It was great. That's adding value. And then post about insurance. It's feed, 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 take. And don't worry about the lack of comments. If you look back through, which by the way, you can follow Jamie and I, you don't have to be our friend on Facebook, but you can follow and see all the things that we have going on over there. I will post a picture about meatloaf for Jimmy John's and have 85 comments. And then I post an insurance post about cancer, and Jamie might be the only person that comments on it. But you know what? I posted a cancer post last Friday, and I've had 4 people personal message me since then. So all the same people that commented on your meatloaf post or your golf post or your crocheting post also saw your post about cancer. So don't let that hurt your feelings. They don't want to maybe comment on there, but they saw it. So don't worry about that. Also show up. Guys, I posted that cancer post on Friday morning, and I went to coffee with a friend of mine, and there were other girls there. And she goes, Sarah, I needed to talk to you. I saw your post about cancer policies. My husband and I both want that. I went shopping a little bit later with my son's girlfriend, and I went into a boutique, and she was like, hey, Sarah, I'm glad I saw you. I want to get that John Hancock policy we talked about a couple of months ago. So this is all, it's not just social media. You're putting those things out there just like you would a billboard or a commercial, but then get out and about. Go to the things you're invited to. If you're invited to a baby shower, go. If you're invited to play in a golf tournament, go. Those same people that saw your posts are also going to talk to you because that's going to jaunt their memory whenever they see you. Be consistent and screenshot things that Jamie and I do, or like Paige is really great on social media too. People are kind of figuring this out. Screenshot it, save an album in your phone of photos so you can look back for inspiration later. You don't want to tag us. That doesn't help us or you. And also don't share it. Just click that share button because the algorithms will not be in your favor. Your network will not see it. So save it, use it for inspiration to write your own a little bit later. And this is my last tip. I was in college and I was told I was not that great of a writer. I got a C in English 101 to just put a big red C at the top of my paper. I remember being like, what? And I just was told by teachers that I wasn't that great of a writer. And now I hear that I am a good writer and it's really interesting to me. But the reason is I finally relaxed and I write like I talk in segments. You'll see a lot of dot, dot, dots. It's not perfect English. It's not perfect grammar. It's okay, but it sounds like how I talk. And if you know Jamie and you look at her post, it sounds exactly like she talks. So be authentic to you and type like you talk, and people can recognize your voice whenever you do it that way.
These are some examples of Instagram and Facebook stories. This is one that I did in August. I love to share what I do in a day in terms of taking care of clients because people are watching exactly what we've been talking about. So you see the post over on the left. It was somebody that reached out looking for insurance quotes. She had found me through a group page on Facebook. She sent me a message. We scheduled a time to connect. The whole purpose is you want to have those referrals. You want people out there to know what it is that you do. So, hey, I got a guy. I know, you know, someone that offers insurance. I got a guy. I know someone that can help you write your will. I have somebody that can, whatever it is that they're looking for, you want to be top of mind for people. So putting it out there on social media just opens up more eyes to what it is that you do. So this was a sequence of stories that brought me a lot more business just from this one day's sequence of stories. So on the left, somebody reached out asking a question. We scheduled a call. Then it was, does your network know what you do? The next page was, hey, I'm Jamie. I'm licensed. This is what I do. The next page, the next story there says, ask me a question. That allows people to type in, you know, what companies do you work with? What does this look like? Could I do something like this? I've been looking at mortgage protection. People write things in there that I can then go back and schedule an appointment. And then on the far right, it says, maybe you have coverage. Maybe you have no idea what you have for coverage. Maybe you just want to know what options could be for you and your loved ones. Picture of one of my business cards. And then I'd be happy to do a free policy review with you. Your network sees that and they're like, oh, Jamie seems cool. I'm going to reach out to her. I'm embarrassed to ask anybody else because I have no idea what coverage I have. Let me be that person to help educate you on what you have and maybe you need more. So this is just an example of a series of stories. I do stories every single day. They are huge for my business, but I don't only post about insurance. Just like Sara said, everyone knows my coffee drink order. Everyone knows I have a baby. Everyone knows I go on date night. I sprinkle it in using that brand matrix, but you better believe it. I love what I do and I'm going to talk about how I can help people.
Yep. And she, I will say, Jamie is absolutely brilliant on stories. Follow her on Instagram. She's probably A+. I'm probably a C+. 5 years older than her. I think it's just enough that I have to think a little bit more about it. So look at my stories too. It's worked. Jamie's worked better. Make sure you look at her on Instagram. She's absolutely brilliant. Some Facebook ideas. This is a couple that we did. Over here on the left, those two are, that's what I posted on Friday. And I just made that really quickly on WordSwag, I think. That's the one that I had one comment. It was Jamie, but I have 4 appointments to put in policies this week from Warm because of that. And she was like, I love when you put trip to Tahiti. I stole that from Jamie, put Tahiti, because I'm like, use the money for what you want. But I've had lots of people reach out to me and say what an impact it had on their cancer journey to have that extra money that came in. So yeah, it's a no-brainer. Absolutely. So 4 policies going in this week because of that post. This is an example of Jamie, and we just have used our business card several times. We took a little screenshot of our business card and we'll post it out there. We use our face. We put our face out there. You know, it has to have some kind of a picture attached or people won't look at it. We just try to share, we educate on what we do. What you have to remember is you can't, people can't get what we have at Costco. You have a state license. You have gone through a lot of training and a huge learning curve to get here. You know more. I have people reach out to me and say, Sara, do not call me an idiot, but I don't know what you're talking about on social media. Will you teach me? Of course I will. I'm a safe place. I said, you know, let's, after the kids are in bed, we'll hop on a Zoom at 9 o'clock and I'll explain it to you. So put it out there, put it in layman's terms, educate them on cancer policies or return a premium. Like, what? You can get all of your money back? Heck yes, you can. Children's policy. Oh, gosh.
You can mute if you want. I'll do that.
So here's some strategies, Jamie. You want to start these?
Yeah. So, I mean, we want people to know about the cancer, heart, and stroke policy, right? We want them to know, just like Sara mentioned, that there's a return of premium option through several of our carriers. We want them to know that there's a quick and instant decision. I had a conversation on Friday with somebody from a Facebook post, and I said, we can have this handled in the next half an hour. Should we take care of this right now? And it was amazing. We got it done. We want to talk about disability, accidental death. I mean, these are strategies that you can put out there today that may not have an immediate return. This is the whole point of this, is you have to be consistent. Who I help today, polls in stories. Polls just mean people can interact. Everyone loves to be able to either answer a question or click, yes, I agree, or I want more information. Please reach out to me. People love doing that. And then did you know, funeral expenses, debt-free life. We have plenty of things to offer, and there is a ton of content available that you can put out there on social.
And guys, here's the thing. We talk a lot about mortality here in this business. I mean, we're in the life insurance business, right? But what Jamie and I want to do is make as many impacts as we possibly can on this earth while we can, right? And we want to impact thousands of humans, whether it's through policies or whether it's through opportunity in working in this business. And listen, we say a lot, like at our funeral, we don't need people to walk by and be like, she made a nutritious meal for her children 7 days a week. That doesn't always happen, but our kids are fine. Don't worry about it. We want people to walk by and be like, man, because of her, I was able to afford this. Because of her, I'm out of debt. Because of her, I was able to pay for my kids' college in cash. And because of her, I was able to pay for my nieces and nephews' college in cash. Because of her, I was a better wife or husband or dad or mom. Because of her, I read more books. Guys, we have huge, huge impacts to make here. We want to be a part of people's story. So it's about impact here, ladies and gentlemen, and you can't make an impact if you're a secret agent, and that's what this business is all about. So hang out your virtual open sign and be so proud of what you do and the products that you offer and the opportunity that you have and the company that you represent, and act like you own it because you do. This thing is way too good not to share. So let's just all go out there and just give it away. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you guys.